This screencast is going to go through an example problem which will give you an idea about the compressibility factor and how we use it to determine certain properties of a gas. First off, I pose the following problem. If we were to place 100 grams of solid CO2, dry ice, into a 2-liter bottle and equilibrate it at 35 degrees Celsius, assuming all of the solid CO2 becomes a gas, what would the pressure be inside of this bottle? Now, I wouldn't suggest doing this at home. But going through the calculation should give you an idea of how dangerous this could be. If we assume that the gas behaves ideally and use the ideal gas equation of state, then we know the pressure is related to the gas constant R times the temperature over the specific molar volume V. We could look up R. In this case, we're going to use 0.08206 liters atmosphere over mole Kelvin. The temperature, 35 degrees, is equivalent to 308 Kelvin, but we don't know the specific molar volume. We're going to have to calculate that. That's the volume over the amount of moles. In this case, the volume is 2 liters, and the amount of moles is the mass of CO2 divided by the molecular weight. When we do this calculation, we get a pressure of approximately 28 atmospheres, which is extremely high for a 2-liter bottle. Now, if we say it doesn't behave ideally, and we want to get an idea of maybe how non-ideal the gas is behaving, we could rewrite the ideal gas law with this new factor Z as such, where when the gas behaves ideally, Z equals 1, and we get the ideal gas law. The farther from 1, the more non-ideal the gas is actually behaving. We're going to call this the compressibility factor. The compressibility factor equation of state would have the following form. Pressure times a specific molar volume is equal to this compressibility factor times the gas constant times temperature. Now, there are two main ways for determining Z. One is to look them up in tables. For instance, Perry's Chemical Engineering Handbook. Knowing a certain pressure and temperature, we could find Z for a species, plug that in, and then solve for the specific volume of the gas, or the amount of moles. In this case, we know the specific volume and we don't know the pressure. So it might be a little tricky to look that up in tables, especially for, say, CO2 at these conditions. The other way to do it is, let's assume we could find a chart that has Z for any conditions for all gases. That'd be pretty ideal. Now, it's tough to find a single chart since gases behave pretty differently. But most gas properties depend very significantly on the proximity of the gas to its critical state. Now, the reduced temperature, TR, is the ratio of the system temperature to the critical temperature. So when this is 1, we know that the gas is at its critical temperature. Same thing for the reduced pressure. So we could use charts that look at gases relative to their critical states. Now, these are going to be called generalized compressibility charts. So to do this, we would need to do the following. The first thing is to look at the critical temperature and critical pressure for the gas of interest. In this case, we're looking at CO2. The critical temperature and critical pressure are the following. This can be found in different handbooks as well as many textbooks with thermodynamic parameters. So we've looked this up to be 304.2 Kelvin and 72.9 atmospheres for CO2. Now, the second thing to do is calculate the reduced variables, such as the reduced temperature, reduced pressure, or the reduced volume. Now, in this specific case, we don't know what the pressure is in our bottle, so we can't calculate the reduced pressure. We can calculate the reduced temperature, which is going to be the temperature over the critical temperature. Our system temperature is 308 Kelvin. We're going to divide that by 304.2 Kelvin. And we should get a value of 1.013. As you can see, there are no units on the reduced temperature. Now, we're going to have to calculate the reduced volume. In this case, the reduced volume in the ideal case, is the ratio of the specific volume to the critical volume, just as the other variables. We're going to take into consideration this ideal case using the ideal gas law and put in the appropriate parameters such that we have the following in the end. In this case, we know the critical pressure and critical temperature because we could look those up as we have. And then we could calculate the specific volume, which we already did for the ideal gas case, and use the gas constant R to get our reduced volume. When we do this, you should get a value of 2.57. Now that we have our reduced ideal volume and our reduced temperature, we're going to go to compressibility charts to figure out what our Z factor is. This is a compressibility chart taken from Felder and Rousseau's Elementary Principles of Chemical Processes, 3rd edition. As you can see on the x-axis, we have the reduced pressure, PR, and the compressibility factor, Z, on the y-axis. Now, at first, this plot could be kind of tricky to read, so let's work through this. You can see the VR ideal right here at 0.07, and it increases through those dashed lines. Now, TR of 1 is represented by this line, and starts going up following those lines. So now the trick is to figure out where our TR and VR cross to determine the compressibility factor Z. So we had a TR of 1.01, so safe to say it's going to be somewhere right in here. If we look at our VR, we had around 2.6. This is going to be somewhere around here. So we see those intersect right about there. Now again, reading off a chart, you may get different values. Now when we go along to the y-axis, I get a z-factor of around 0.88. So going back to our compressibility factor equation of state, we can see that the pressure is going to be equal to zRT over the molar volume V. And in this case, we have 0.88 times pretty much the same value we got from the ideal gas equation, RT over specific volume V. And we have 28 atmospheres. So this pressure is around 24.6 atmospheres. So using the Z factor approximation, we got 24.6 atmospheres. And using the ideal gas law, we got around 28 atmospheres. So the percent error can be calculated as the following, which results in 13.6% error. As you can see, 24 to 28 atmospheres is a high pressure to have in a bottle and can be very dangerous, especially if the bottle can't hold that kind of pressure. Hopefully, this gave you an idea of how to calculate specific variables associated with a gas using the compressibility factor equation of state.